Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome, welcome, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And if you're a low subscriber, you already know the drill. So we're just gonna talk about my post-grad feelings, my last semester of school, going into the job hunting, trying to figure out what career path I wanna take. We're just gonna see where it goes and what I can fit in to 12 minutes because I don't wanna keep rambling to you guys. I want this to not be a movie. If I had one word to describe my last semester of college, would be nervous or chaotic or just sitting at the edge of my seat, because I'm gonna be real with y'all, I did not think I was gonna graduate on time. I was retaking my genetic class, one of the two biggest classes you ever have to take as a biology major, and they're the freaking hardest, and it was only offered in the fall. So I was just like, yo, if I fail this class, I'm gonna have to come back in 2021 and still not even have my degree. Yeah, I was going through it. Not even to mention, like, Corona did not help that much. I'm so grateful that God knew me well enough to know that he had to pass me, because this online school thing, not for me. I really applaud all you students that are still in school doing school online, because I know from the three months I had to do it, I hated it. I was under a lot of pressure in my last semester of college, just trying to make sure that I graduated. I would never decree and declare depression, but I was going through it. Right after I did my last final, it was like so weird. When you're in college, it's like, I just want this to end. Like, this is excruciating. This is annoying. I don't even want to be here anymore. At this point, I feel like I'm here for my parents. I'm here for my family. I'm here for people that are proud of me. Like, I don't want to do this anymore. So when you finally go through all of that and then you're done at the finish line, you're like, okay, so like, what next? If you're like me, I have to always have something going on. And now when you graduate from college, you no longer have that safety net of saying, I'm in school. That was very scary for me and I did not take that well. Post-grad depression is very real, but I wouldn't say that I was depressed. I would say I was just really sad. I was never one of those kids that knew from 5 years old that I wanted to be a doctor, or I wanted to be an astronaut, or I wanted to be a chef. Like, I was never that kid, and I always put it off, especially when I got to college. I was like, oh, I'll figure out by my sophomore year, I'll figure out by my junior year. Like, the senior year hit and it's just like, no, seriously, Lashanya, you're like, what are we doing? We have a life that we want to live. I finally have time to learn who I am, because I'm no longer in the system that's constantly pushing us to the next thing. Like, when you're in kindergarten, you know you're going to first grade. After fifth grade, you know you're going to sixth. After junior year, senior year, you know you're going to college. Now I'm finally at that point in my life where there's a question mark there, and it's like, it's driving me insane. Like, at this point, I'm praying every day, like, God, show me a sign. Where do I need to go? Who do I need to talk to? I kept talking to people that were older than me, thinking that they would give me the answer. But after probably 3 months, I realized nobody knows the answer to life. Like, no one knows the answer to what is your next, ever. You can sit there and talk to people that are older than you till your face turns blue, but nobody knows the answer to what is your next. And that took me a while, because I'm just like, yo, like, somebody tell me what is going on. I felt like a chicken running with my head cut off. Like, why does nobody have the answer? We just have to fall in love with the unknown. It's so funny, because I saw this video, she was just like, I don't have a dream job because I don't dream of working. And I'm like, period, sis. Like, I like to travel, I like to see new places, I like to eat new food. Ain't nobody dreaming about work. I want to get my money so I can live my lavish life. But at the end of the day, I knew that I wanted to be somewhere that I was appreciated and that I was, you know, welcome for who I am and not who they want to conform me to be. I want to be somewhere that I'm in front of other people and communicating and engaging with other people, and not necessarily just sitting in a cubicle and doing my day job. I wanted to be somewhere that I was represented, that was gonna welcome me and allow me to grow. That's my consensus now. But before, I was so focused on, wait, I got a degree in biology, like, I can't work in tech. And I'm gonna tell you guys this right now. Your degree, and this is gonna sting because it stung me, your degree does not matter. It broke my heart. I would say, like, when I first graduated, I wanted to find a job, I wanted to figure things out, but it was just like, Corona came and nobody was really hiring anyway, so it was just like, let's just sit back. And I did that until I moved out of my college apartment and I moved back in with my parents. And that's when I realized, like, honestly, I don't see my life here in the Lehigh Valley. I'm the type of person that I like to travel. I like to go places. I don't want to stay here. So what we're going to do, we're going to get out of this little funky funk and we're going to get on the computer and we're going to network. So I started to upload my resume. I started networking with people at different top companies. I was like, listen, sky's the limit. We're going to go big or we're going to go home. I started going to all the job fairs that Temple had, because as a graduate, you still have access to those job fairs. You still have access to the career centers. Even though you're no longer there, still make use of what your money paid for. You're going to milk that cow till it falls over. STEM majors, on the side of probably like the business majors, are kind of like the two cocky kids. So it's like coming out of the market, knowing like, I worked my butt off for this degree. This degree was not easy. I'm thinking, okay, I'll get a job in no time. Your damn degree does not mean anything to anybody. It's a cold world we live in. They don't care how hard you worked on your degree. It does not matter to anybody. So then getting those rejection letters, I've probably gotten 101. Like, I applied to so many jobs. I have tailored my cover letter to every single one of those. And it was just like, why am I not getting a job? Then you fall into that part of, am I not good enough? Then you fall into that part of life where you're like, did I study the wrong thing? Then you'll end up talking to people. They're like, yeah, like, you'll do well here at XYZ, our company, and they'll never talk to you again. They get your hopes up, then disappear. And it's just like, what the hell is going on? What is my life? I went through my moments where I would literally just close my bedroom door and just cry underneath my blanket like a big baby, because it's just like, I honestly felt like a loser. I was gonna live in my parents' basement forever. It just like, that's how I was feeling. Till I came to a conclusion that when you get rejections, even though it stings a little bit, especially if it's from a company that you want to work for, that's a good thing, because it's not for you. What is for you would never miss you, would never leave you, and I am a strong believer in that. Sometimes that is not your blessing. That position could possibly be someone else's blessing. Someone could possibly need that job more than you. Because if you don't, you're going to end up taking rejections very hard. And I don't even feel like from transitioning into the corporate world, that's not what they're really trying to do. They're not trying to hurt your feelings. It's honestly because they found a better candidate. Don't take it personal. And when I say that your major doesn't matter, I'm not telling you to not go to college. A college is pointless. I'm not saying that. I feel like college, everyone should go to college if you want to, if you want to get that experience, especially because you will never get that type of experience again, especially if you go to a big university. But what I'm saying when I say that is, don't make your major limit you to what you want to be. That's why I'm saying that. I thought I studied biology, so I have to do something in biology. Until I got over that, that's when I realized the world is my oyster. Like, I could do anything. So don't ever let your major stop you from wanting to pursue a certain industry, ever. You're like, but I spent so much money on it, it's really trying. I know. But if another company that's not in your industry gonna give you 100K salary, you gonna turn it down? Is that what we're doing? No. But unless you really want to go to med school, unless you really want to go to dent, all of that, yes, having that degree is nice. But at the end of the day, you don't even need a biology degree to go to med school. You don't need a biology degree to go to dent school. Literally, those schools, matter of fact, you don't even need a full bachelor's to get into pharm. You just need the whole prerequisites. Like, it's crazy when you learn these loopholes that people do not tell you about. A lot of people do not tell you these things, and they're wicked.
It's an evil world we live in.
That's a whole nother video in itself. After I got over that, I decided that I wanted to apply to a tech company, a huge tech company, Fortune 500 type. I'm just like, you know what? Sky's the limit. Okay, we're not gonna downplay our abilities. And luckily I was able to land an internship I didn't even think I was gonna get. And you know what's funny? That little negative energy that was telling me that I wouldn't be able to get it because I didn't have a tech background. And guess what? I got it. So that's why I'm saying, do not let your degree make you feel like you cannot do something, because you can do it. As long as you could sell yourself and sell what you can do, and you know what you're capable of doing and how you could meet those job requirements, baby, you got it. Don't doubt yourself. Don't doubt your capabilities. And it's so funny because my manager actually has a doctorate in chemistry. One thing I've learned from all my chaotic feelings from graduating to the corona, then not having a job, trying to find a job, then finally landing an internship 6 months later. If you don't get anything from this video, I want you to get this one thing. Fall in love with the unknown. Do not let the unknown eat you alive. Once you graduate, your life has a question mark on it, and it's really up to you on who you want to be. That is very nerve-wracking when you think about it. It is really up to you. No one's telling you the next steps anymore. Network until your face turns blue. When people don't respond, don't take that one person not responding to you to not talk to other people. There's 7 point something billion people in the world. Keep talking. It's not about what you know, it's who you know and who's gonna put you in what room to speak with somebody else. You have to be patient. All my friends know, my family know, I have zero to no patience. So this hit hard. For me, I was just like, listen, I'm just gonna pray every day and I'm just gonna let God guide me wherever he guides me. I need to have trust and faith in him that I'll be okay. And that is what's getting me through it. I'm just falling in love with not knowing what the hell's going on next. Because as long as you know that you're doing what you need to do to get to the next level, screw what anybody else has to say. This is your life. Everyone has a different path. As long as you're not sitting on your couch watching TV, eating potato chips every day, not doing anything productive to try to catapult your life into anything, then we have a problem. I'm gonna need you to get up. I'm gonna need you to get on LinkedIn. I'm gonna need you to connect with some people, at least try. Sending one job application a day, you're trying. So you got post-grad feelings, transitioning into the adult world for me, and finally landing an internship and my tips and advice on that. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you gained some knowledge from this. I hope this helped you in some type of way. You'll be okay, keep pushing through. Your calling is right there. Before you know it, it'll pop up and you'll be in positions that you never thought you would ever be in. So have a good day, have a happy day, have a blessed day, and I'll see you in my next video that I'm probably gonna film right now.